Hey, High Levelers. If you have clients or in your business, if you accept payments through Highlevel, then you're going to want to watch this video because we're going to be covering how to use the text to pay feature. My name is Rayo Daniel. I want to thank you to my channel. If you have not subscribed, please hit the subscribe button and hit the bell button to get notified whenever we publish new videos. So in this particular video, it's going to be really short because this isn't a complicated feature, but I wanted to show it to you because I think it's really cool. So right now, we're in a demo account. Now, this is when we use text-to-pay is not technically doing invoicing. If you want to know how to do invoicing, I'll quickly show you on this video, but I have a whole other video on my channel that covers invoicing, how to build invoicing, and how to do your taxes and things like that. Text-to-pay is really just a very quick way of sending a request out to get money in. And there are differences between that. So you might have like a strategy call or even like a coaching call that you are on and you want to bill the client real quick before you actually have the call. So this right here is a great way to be able to do that. So right now to show you this, I've got a demo account created. And what you're going to do is you're going to come into your contacts area. Now, I will let you know text to pay is a manual process. Okay, it is not an automated process. Currently right now through the Highlevel software, there is no way to automate invoices. There is no way to automate text to pay. There's just no way to do it right now because the invoicing as well as the text to pay require your input in order for you to send it. Now, with invoicing, that doesn't mean that you cannot have reoccurring invoices. So once you watch the video, you can have reoccurring monthly invoices for payments that you want to receive, and those can be automated, but you have to create the invoice first before you can do that. So here, what we're going to do is demonstrate the text to pay feature. So let's just say I'm going to pick this lady, Jane Smith here. We're going to be doing a strategy call, and I want to charge her $150 for the strategy call before we have our appointment later on this afternoon. So if I want to send that over to her real quick, I can just simply do this. Now we're doing text to pay because most people have a mobile device and most people can get text messages faster than they can get emails, because when you invoicing goes out in an email, it doesn't go out in a text message. So being able to have a text message with a little quick link to pay and have everything mobile friendly is a very good way to be able to do this. Now, if you're communicating with your clients and they're not expecting a text from you, then this is where the problem comes into, because they're going to get a text. They're going to be getting a text from your business number. So from whatever number you have defined as your default inside of Highlevel, which we could take a look at that real quick. But that number has to be programmed in their phone as coming from you. If not, they're going to get a text to pay with a link from a strange number, and most likely they're not going to click on it and pay it unless your phone number is recognized in their phone system and you've communicated with them, letting them know that you're going to be sending them a text to pay link. That becomes a very trusted text message source. They feel comfortable clicking on the link and going and paying the bill. So first of all, let's hop in real quick here. If you want to find out your phone number, you're just going to simply click on your settings, come over here to your phone number, and whatever's listed as default, this default outbound number here will be the number that your text message or text to pay will come from. So if your clients don't have this number in their phone, I would have to highly recommend having them put that in their phone, because if not, it looks like it's scam when people receive a text message from an unknown number, and then it becomes even harder. So if you can have your clients put this number in their phone, that would be outstanding. Back to Jane, you're gonna just select the person, whoever it is that you wanna click. Now, when you're doing this, you do need to open up and go inside of the contact level to do this text to pay feature. You cannot do this. You cannot select two records and then click text to pay. You can't do that. Right now, that's not supported. Text to pay is a one-to-one individual link connection. So you have to open up an individual record. Now, because you're doing text to pay, I know this seems kind of silly to bring it up, but the client has to have a phone number, and that phone number has to be SMS capable. It cannot be a landline, because you're not going to be able to obviously send a text message to a landline. So it has to have a phone number. The phone number has to be good, and it has to have SMS enabled on it. So most of them do, but in order for this feature to work, that's what you have to do. So just put you some prerequisites down. Now, inside of here, inside of this conversations area here in the middle, this is where we're going to focus. So I'm going to blow this up. What we're looking at is a small little icon in the bottom of the screen here, and it's kind of hard to see. So here, if we look at the bottom of the screen, we have an SMS. We sit back and we can use a template if we want to send an SMS message, but we're going to use this little circular with a dollar sign right here. So this little guy right here that says request payment. So that's where it is. So you're going to come down here and you're going to request payment. Now, what you're going to get is something very similar to an invoice screen. You're going to get something that you have to type in. It's not going to be manual. There's no templates. There's no select from product list kind of thing like you would normally be able to do in an invoice. This is not how the text to pay feature works. So I can just simply just type in something like consulting call. Choose $150. Here's the invoice date. And if you ever wanted to do optional, these are, you know, if you ever wanted to put your payments in test mode and test things, you could do that. But right here, this is what the screen looks like. This is all it looks like. If you wanted to, you can click on this preview. It'll take you out there and show you what this looks like. So here it is. It uses the invoicing method. So it's not like literally creating an invoice, but using text to pay creates an invoice in your system that you can track, and we will take a look at that. But the beauty of this is that you see your agency, it has all of your invoicing settings on it, your header, any of those things that we have covered in the other video regarding invoicing, all of those settings and prerequisites that you have come in, and it generates a nice little invoice, consulting call, $150, and then you can simply send this out. Now, if you copy this link, you can say copy and mark is sent. This right here then creates, I'll blow this up, creates a nice little SMS message. Please use this link to pay. Redirects over here. And then at that point, you can send now. Now, I'm not going to send this because this is a fake number. It won't work. It'll come back as failed anyway. But I wanted to go through the process to show you what the text to pay feature creates. So now that we've gone through that, we've actually created something. We haven't sent it yet. But you can just simply click send now. It'll send out the SMS message from your base default phone number out to the person. Now let's go over here and take a look in your payments area. Notice in your payments area here, we have now have a text to pay. Notice that this is different from this other invoice that we have in the system. This just says invoice. This is a text to pay, as well as notice the icon different change. This is an invoice. This is the text to pay. Feature. So they are different invoices, but they use the same invoicing numbers. Notice that your invoice number gets incremented from 4 to 5. This is the person on this date for this amount due in 4 days. So the nice thing about this is that even though you can quickly send a text to pay feature to have somebody click and pay it real quick, it still does show up underneath your invoices and payments, which means now you can be able to track it. So now you see that this is due in 4 days. You can see when it's overdue. You can sit back and contact them, and you actually can get notified when they receive payments as well. So the payment, you know, gets shown up, it'll show as paid, and then once it's paid, then you can simply move on with your consulting call because they paid for it and everything is all well. So it's a really quick setting on here, but I do want to sit back and just go over this so that you understand that that nice little cool feature is there in case you ever want to use it. The text to pay feature is really just a really quick way of getting it out and getting it into their SMS messages. So that's a quick way because text message responses are much higher than email message responses. Some people I know don't check email, but maybe every couple of hours or even once a day. Sometimes not even that when they check their emails, but they do look at their text messages. So I hope you found the video useful. If you did, please leave me a comment. If you have any questions, please leave a comment with a question. I do get back to everybody. I do appreciate you visiting my channel. If you have not subscribed, please do so. If you are interested in signing up for Highlevel, please use my affiliate link below. I do offer lots of bonuses for those people that set up, as well as strategy calls with me to be able to get you up and going as soon as possible. Thank you very much, and you guys have a great day. Hey, if you're interested in learning more about Highlevel, click on the link below regarding my free Highlevel course. It goes over everything that you need to do to get your account created, get it set up, and get it going in about 2 days. I also, if you sign up with Highlevel with me, I do offer a snapshot as well as a client onboarding course that can be used by your client or even used to train your own team to do client onboarding. I want to thank you so much again and have a great day.